Right now, stay tuned as Phyllis celebrates her 45th birthday with guest Mary Tyler Moore. Next.
This has been a J&M production, and this is Don Wilson saying good night.
What did he say?
He said it's a pleasure.
New comedy with the Betty White Show.
That's more than he said to me on our entire honeymoon. I see you still have your mustache. Or did you have anchovies for lunch?
All right, where is she?
Where's who?
Your mother.
I only get homemade waffles when your mother's coming or when you wrecked a car.
The car.
Those aren't homemade. Those are Eggo waffles.
They aren't homemade?
They taste more like homemade than the other leading waffle.
They sure do.
They give you more of that great homemade flavor.
Your mother's not coming?
No.
Good. And let go my Eggo.
Eggo waffles. They taste more like homemade.
From Kellogg's.
A Brookline sex ring charges. Details at 11.
Charms of crabs, of fishermen, pork right out of their shells. Who lights the lamps of Chinatown just by walking in view? Phyllis, it sure isn't you.
Given the evidence, Phyllis, I can think of only two possibilities. Either we're putting a puzzle together or we're taking it apart very slowly.
Oh, I love jigsaw puzzles. What's it a picture of?
We don't know, dear. It's what the game store calls a mystery special. There's no picture to guide you.
Oh, how awful. You have to go through all that agony without even knowing if you're going to like what it looks like.
Yes, it's a little like motherhood.
What's new in your life, Phyllis?
You know what the day after tomorrow is? My birthday.
Oh, how old will you be, Phyllis?
45. Isn't that a shock?
I'll say I'd have guessed 50.
Jonathan, you should be in bed.
It's only 10 o'clock, and tomorrow's not school day.
The wrestling matches, Mother Dexter.
Wait, the main event was Killer Typhoon versus the Beast of Bakersfield. Well, in the second round, Killer threw the beast out of the ring, and he fell right in my lap. All 375 luscious pounds of him.
Oh, Mother Dexter. How I envy your zest for life. There's nothing in this world that seems to excite me anymore.
Oh, you should try the Beast of Bakersfield in your lap.
Phyllis is upset because day after tomorrow is her 45th birthday, and she feels her whole life is, what shall I say?
Down the toilet.
Mother.
That's exactly right. There's nothing exciting about my life.
If you want excitement, Phyllis, you have to make it yourself.
That's right. Instead of moaning about your birthday, why don't you celebrate it?
Give a party. Laugh, sing, get it on.
A wonderful idea. And how typical of you, my dear good friends, to think of it in order to cheer me when I'm feeling low. I'll do it. I'll have a party. You'll come, won't you, Jonathan?
I'm sorry, Phyllis. I have a meeting that night.
Audrey?
I'm afraid I promised to visit my sister.
Aren't you going to invite me?
Well, I just assumed you
You wouldn't be interested in coming.
No. Why should you assume that, dear?
Well, I just assumed you would have other plans.
No, no, I have no other plans.
Then you'll come?
To your birthday party?
Yes.
I'd rather have a root canal.
Just a small party, but I'd love to have you.
I appreciate it, Lindstrom, but it just so happens that Friday is also my sister's birthday, and she's having a party, too.
I understand.
And if I'm not going to go to her party, I'm certainly not going to go to yours.
Maybe I shouldn't toss this party after all. Birthday parties are for the young, and tomorrow I shall turn, dare I say it, why not, 42.
Half want to vote funds for additional daycare centers, the other half don't. I have the deciding vote.
How are you voting?
Len Marsh votes his conscience. I'm abstaining.
A real gutsy decision, Leonard.
Hey, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. Say, I gotta get going.
Wait, please, Leonard, before you go, tomorrow's my birthday, and I'm having a party. Can you come?
Let me say this about that. I'd be pleased and honored to attend.
Oh, Len, thank you.
Who else is coming?
Nobody.
Let me say this about that. Unfortunately, when you tendered your kind invitation, I was unaware of a conflict on my calendar. Sorry. I'll be in my office the rest of the afternoon.
Do you need anything?
Set up a conflict on my calendar.
Harriet, how would you like to come to my party?
Me? Phyllis, we don't even like each other.
I know, but it's just a birthday party.
Oh, poor Phyllis. It must be terrible not to have any friends.
Not having any friends?
Well, that's what it sounds like.
Don't be absurd. I have lots of friends back in Minneapolis. Real friends. Friends for life. Friends who would do anything for me. Get the feeling you don't believe me.
Whatever gave you that idea?
Operator, I'd like to call Minneapolis, please.
Phyllis, what are you doing?
Yes, person to person. In fact, friend to friend. Mary Richards, 555-7862.
Phyllis, why are you calling her?
I want to prove a point. A real friend is somebody who would drop whatever she's doing and come here just because I asked her, and that's the kind of friend I have. Hello, Mary.
This is Phyllis.
I need you to come to San Francisco right now. Today, right this minute. Please, Mary, don't ask any questions. Will you come?
Well, sure, I guess so. Yes, of course, Phyllis, but...
Thank you, Mary.
That's a friend.
Wow, I'm impressed.
I should hope so.
I misjudged you, Phyllis. I must confess, I always thought you were the screwiest woman in the whole world. It's not true.
Your friend Mary is. Operator, would you please get me Minneapolis?
Uh-huh.
555-7862. Thank you. Not have any friends. Oh, the line's busy. Wait, operator. Let me ask you a question. If someone called you and asked you to fly from Minneapolis to San Francisco with no explanation, you wouldn't actually do it, would you? No, me either. I mean, if she were seriously considering coming, she'd call back and find out what the matter was. Oh, well, thank you for all your help. I must say, I think it's wonderful the way the telephone company's hiring male operators like yourself. Oh, sorry, miss.
I'm Mary Richards. You must be Judge Dexter?
Yes, yes, of course, Mary Richards. Phyllis talks about you all the time.
Almost as much as she talks about herself.
I'm Audrey Dexter.
Hello. Where is Phyllis?
She's upstairs.
How is she?
Oh, she's fine.
Good, good. And how is everything?
Couldn't be better.
Oh, good. Good.
How's everything with you?
Why, Mary, Phyllis.
What a nice surprise. What brings you here?
Phyllis, you called me. Of course.
Right. Oh, silly me.
I don't know what I was thinking of. How was the flight?
Terrible. Phyllis, what?
You probably don't get a movie between here and Minneapolis, do you?
No movie. And the stove broke, so no hot food. And the airport was foggy, and we had to circle for 2 hours. And Phyllis, I think I'm getting a cold.
Oh.
And it's 1 o'clock in the morning my time, Phyllis. Oh. So will you please tell me why?
Did you meet
me?
Everybody?
Yes, Phyllis, I did. I met them. Jonathan,
very nice meeting you. And if you'd excuse us, it's past our bedtime.
Sure, we understand, don't we, Mary?
No.
Yes, I'm sorry.
Good night.
Good night.
Phyllis! For God's sake, will you tell me why I'm
wonderful
here?
Wonderful people, aren't they? It's funny, I've lived here almost a year.
Phyllis,
and yet I just flew
from Minneapolis to be here with you because you said you needed me, and I want to know why. Right now, Phyllis. Now. Right now.
Mary. You're my closest friend. And I've known you too long to lie to you. I'm going to tell you the truth about, you know, what happened. Why I called you and asked if you'd fly out here.
It just better be good.
Mary. I'm pregnant.
Our dog Skipper had been missing for 3 days when the Harrisons found him. I was so worried he hadn't eaten. He won't eat anything that doesn't come out of a can. He's been eating Gaines burgers?
Why not? It's moist and meaty like canned, and it tastes terrific.
Look at that. He loves it.
Yeah. Now, how about something for the rest of us, huh?
Moist and meaty Gaines burgers dog food. Beef, egg, and cheese flavor.
With a big family, you learn the value of a dollar. We save any way we can. So when our home needed painting, we saved with paint on sale from the people who paint the great American homes. Sears Best, one coat flat exterior. Only $7.99. Save $4. And Sears, one coat latex fashion flat and semi-gloss. Only $7.99. Save $3. And they're both washable.
All only $7.99 each. The Great American Paint Sale. Now at Sears.
Pregnant? By whom?
I don't know.
Of course, I didn't mean that the way it sounds. I wouldn't want you to think.
When did you find out?
Find out what? About the pregnancy. Well, I'm not entirely pregnant. What do you mean, not entirely pregnant? Phyllis, look at me.
Well, I'm not really pregnant. I just made that up because I was ashamed to admit the truth. See, Mary, I didn't actually mean for you to come out here.
You asked me to!
I know, but that was just a test, so it's really a good joke on the both of us that you're here.
A joke?
Well, someday we're gonna laugh at this.
You made me leave home without even time to change clothes or pack properly and get on a plane with no food and no movie and fly to San Francisco.
I'm really sorry about the movie.
Well, you didn't even need me. Phyllis, how could you?
Of course, the food. I'd be glad to make you something.
How could you do something like this, Phyllis? You are despicable.
Despicable. I'd be glad to pop something in the oven for you.
Despicable, Phyllis. This is the worst, most lame brain, arrogant thing you have ever done in your life.
I think the important thing here is not to lose our sense of humor.
Humor? I want to scream. I want to smack you in the face. I'd like to break every bone in your stupid little body.
I think it's wonderful the way you're taking this, Mary.
Just shut your mouth and don't say another word.
Excuse me. I hate to interrupt this happy reunion. But I made up the spare bed in your room for your friend, dear.
Thank you, Audrey.
I hope you'll stay the night with us. I'm sure you two have a lot to talk about.
Oh. Mary, dear, funny Mary. Oh, Mary. You know you can't stay angry with me for long, not with silly Philly. Mary, where's that big smile?
Come on, Mary. Don't you have a little smile for Phyllis? Just one smile. Come on, Mary.
Stop that, Phyllis. Stop it, or you'll never point again.
Mary, I know what I did may seem unforgivable, but you still haven't heard my reason for doing it. See, Mary, I had to prove I had a friend. And this was the only way I could do it because, Mary, you're the only friend I have.
Had.
Mary, what I just told you was pitiable. Weren't you listening? I just admitted to you that I have no friends. I think a little sympathy is called for.
Well, you're not getting it. You know why you have no friends, Phyllis? Because you are completely wrapped up in yourself. You never consider other people. You never give them one thought.
Excuse me, young lady. Now, this is none of my business because I don't know who you are or what this is about or whose slav is it or who's right or who's wrong. But I'd like to offer one piece of advice. Nail her!
It's true, Phyllis. You're totally wrapped up in yourself. Well, other people have feelings too, you know. You're absolutely right. I am too wrapped up in myself. But I can change. It must be possible. Look at you, Mary. You're considerate, helpful, and giving. And if an ordinary person like you can be like that, I should be wonderful at it. You'll see, Mary, I'm going to become the most compassionate, helpful person in the world.
Do what you like, Phyllis. I'm getting ready for bed.
Who was that?
Yes, may I help you?
Yes, I'd like to see one of the supervisors. The taxes on my house were just doubled, and nobody at the assessor's office will even talk to them.
Oh, would you have a seat, please? As soon as one of the supervisors is free, I'll have him speak with you.
Thank you.
Hello, Harriet.
Hi, Phyllis. How are you?
That's not important anymore. The only thing that interests me is how you are. How are you, Harriet?
Fine.
Harriet, I know, and you know, that you and I haven't exactly hit it off. But this is a new Phyllis you're looking at. A Phyllis who wants to be your friend. One who cares about you and wants to share your problems with you. What are your problems, Harriet?
None of your business, Phyllis.
Harriet, trust me, I want to help you. Phyllis, this is really very nice of you, but I don't happen to have any problems at the moment. I'm really very happy with the way my life is going. Nobody is totally happy with his life. Now, what is it you don't like about yours? Is it this job? Is it the fact that you're overworked, underpaid, not really appreciated? Is it that you realize you have no future here, no chance for advancement, that it's a complete dead end?
I like my job. Sort of.
There must be something else. Is it your personal life? The fact that you're not married and you don't even have any prospects?
Phyllis, the reason that I am not married is for the very simple reason that I have not found anybody that I want to be married to yet. Except maybe Al.
What is it that bothers you? Is it your personal appearance? The fact that you don't dress well and you don't know what to do with your hair?
No, that doesn't bother me.
Did it bother Al?
Excuse me.
That's it, Harriet. Let it all out.
Leonard, how can you abstain on your vote? I mean, there are thousands of women in this city who can't take jobs because they have no place to leave their children.
I understand that, Dan, but a lot of people resent paying taxes for daycare centers for other people's children. I have to think about everybody. Can't just turn my back on the child haters.
Abstaining is not going to help anybody.
If more people abstained in the first place, we wouldn't have all these children to worry about now.
Don't fight.
We're not fighting, Liston. We're discussing the daycare center.
No. Come on, guys. It isn't the daycare center that's the problem here. The real problem here is that you don't like each other, and I want to help you solve that problem.
What are you talking about, Phyllis? I like Dan. He likes me. We're just having a political disagreement, but we still like each other.
Sure.
No, you don't. And if we're going to solve this problem, we first have to get you both to agree that it exists. Now, Dan, be honest. You think Leonard is dumb, don't you?
Lindstrom?
You think he's a yo-yo. Admit it.
You think that?
Yes, he does. And Leonard, you think Dan is an arrogant, self-righteous spaghetti bender.
That's not true. I think you're one of the nicest spaghetti benders I know. At least I did until you started calling me a yo-yo.
I didn't call you a yo-yo. She called you a yo-yo.
But you didn't deny it. The truth, Dan. Do you think I'm a yo-yo or not?
I abstain.
Hey, lady. I thought we were friends. From now on, it's strictly business between you and me, Buster. You just keep your distance.
Leonard, you're acting like a jerk about all of this.
Oh, I'm a jerk now, am I?
Now we're getting somewhere.
Just stay out of my way, Valenti.
It's my pleasure, Marsh.
Now we can start building a real friendship. May I help you?
No.
Yeah, my plane leaves in an hour.
Do you have time for a piece of birthday cake?
No, I don't feel like any birthday cake, Phyllis.
In the office today, I tried to do what you said. I tried to be caring and considerate. I thought it was working at first, but by the end of the day, nobody would even come near me. They hate me. Gave me lousy advice, Mary Richards. I don't know why I even came to San Francisco in the first place.
Oh, yeah, I remember. Phyllis, you can't expect to make friends in one day.
Why not? I lose them that fast.
Well, I gotta get going. I'll miss my plane.
Gee, Mary, I hate having you leave here mad.
Yeah, me too, but this was just a little too much to shrug off.
I'm really sorry. Sorrier than I've ever been about anything I ever did.
Okay, I accept that. I forgive you. It's over, done. Forget it. Goodbye, Phyllis.
Happy birthday.
Oh, Phyllis, don't do this.
Happy birthday to...
Because I've really got to leave, and that's it. I'm sorry. Goodbye,
Happy
Phyllis.
Happy birthday. Dear Phil.
Oh, Phil.
Happy birthday to you.
Confessions from the No Bra Generation.
Without a bra, I'm shapeless.
Who can wear a bra under halters and plunges and still look natural?
Help!
Playtex did. Introducing new Free Spirit convertible bra.
Looks No Bra natural. Converts three ways. Hides under barest halters.
Plunges. Even crisscross.
Soft tricot cups hug smooth as skin.
New Free Spirit convertible from Playtex.
Three great ways to look No Bra natural.
That's a cowboy hat, Charlie.
Yeah.
Wow. Say something in cowboy.
Dallas, Houston, Fort White.
That's good.
Yeah, I'm going to race thoroughbred horses to show Star-Kist my good taste. There's a horse now.
Star-Kist doesn't want tunas with good taste.
I host Star-Kist.
Star-Kist wants tunas that taste good.
Sorry, Charlie. Only good-tasting tuna get to be Star-Kist. Good-tasting 100% tuna filet.
This is good-tasting tuna.
Get good taste. Get Star-Kist.
Thank you for staying, Mary. I feel terrible about having made you miss your plane.
Oh, well, planes come and go, but friendships like ours, you can't get rid of.
That's true. Sometimes I wonder why you remain my friend.
Well, it's a dirty job, Phil, but someone has to do it.
the birthday girl. And I see all your friends have arrived.
You two didn't... You saw each other last night, but I didn't get a chance to introduce you properly. Mother Dexter, this is my very dear and close friend from Minneapolis about whom I've told you so much.
Oh, so nice to meet you, Rhoda.
No, Mother Dexter, this is Mary Richards.
Oh, the old maid. Listen, dear, I think there's hope for you yet. But I just want to give you a word of advice. Now, the next time you latch on to a fella, try holding out a little longer. I mean, a man's not going to buy a cow if he can have the milk for free.
Oh, no, Mother Dexter, I know what you're doing. Phyllis told me all about you. How you say shocking things and try to catch people off guard. How you try to embarrass them. Well, it's not going to work with me. There's nothing you can say that'll embarrass me.
No way, huh? Come here, honey. I like your friend.
The contract.
You can have one more year at the top.
Who are you kidding? I'm still Billy Worthy.
The biggest star! Oh, take my soul! Give me one more year at the top!
A year at the top is a devil of a show.
Me, 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 me.
Premiering Friday, August 5th at 8:30, 7:30 Central and Mountain.
You're the one.
You're the one, Bill Quigley.
We do it all for you.
For you, every McDonald's hamburger is made from 100% pure beef. Sears sizzle to seal in the flavor. For you, every McDonald's hamburger is made with care by people who understand quality.
Quarter pound, please.
Just made, Mr. Quigley.
For you, Bill Quigley.
Thank you.
Volkswagen presents an energy proposal for government. For the Secretary of Interior, we propose a Dasher with one of the roomiest interiors in its class. For the Secretary of State, who's always zipping to airports, our Scirocco sports car, which zips from 0 to 50 in 7.5 seconds. And for our Treasurer, who understands big economy, our Big Economy Rabbit. Now that's an energy proposal without sacrifice.
A flyer with a dangerous sideline gets his wings clipped by Hawkeye on MASH, starring Alan Alda next. Then Anne's hopes and dreams take a nosedive when she loses a promotion to a less qualified person on One Day at a Time.
From CBS News, this is Newsbreak. Today, the Congress gave the president what he asked for and created a new Department of Energy, the first new cabinet-level agency since 1966. Another effort is being made on Capitol Hill tonight to agree on an air pollution bill, one that will satisfy the automakers and avert the threatened shutdown of the auto industry. President Carter says 11 million Americans smoke marijuana regularly, and possession of less than an ounce of it should not be a criminal offense. He's asked Congress to change the law. In the United States next month, Arab and Israeli foreign ministers may have a mini Middle East peace conference to gear up for a full-scale peace conference in Geneva later on. Money Magazine says Billy Carter's personal appearances will make him $500,000 this year. Brother Jimmy makes only $200,000.
This remarkable scientific medicine helps relieve most cold symptoms caused by every known virus. Every known virus. It's Contact.
I'm Morton Dean, CBS News, New York. More news later on this CBS station. Something's in
the air. Patrick McGoohan is Rafferty.
You let one of those scalpel hounds go in there, curiosity cutting, you're liable to end up with a basket case. Stay out, unless you know what you're after.
A tough, outspoken doctor. Rafferty, new this fall on CBS.
Okay, Grandpa, Matthew wants to talk to you. Bye. Go on, Matthew, say something.
Come on, Matthew, say hi to Grandpa.
When you dial direct, no operator involved, after 5 p.m., you can call out of state, anywhere in the country, and talk 10 minutes for only $2.60 or less. It's a great way to listen to your grandchildren grow.
Dad, I guess Matthew isn't going to say anything. Bye-bye.
Hello, Grandpa. Are you there? This is Matthew.
It's the biggest. It's the best. It's fun. And beyond. The spy who loved me. He makes his most beautiful friends and meets his most dangerous enemies. The spy who loved me.
Starts tomorrow, Sac Pie Alley and Savoy Theater, Cinemas Natick, Woburn, Dedham, and Danvers.
The school committee claims victory at 11.
MASH. Sponsored by Prudential. Life, health, auto, and home insurance are available from a Prudential agent. Get a piece of the rock. Prudential Insurance.